Today, the nation celebrates the life and legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.
The civil rights champion would have turned 91 last week.
Let's take a live look right now at the MLK Memorial in Washington, D.C. A wreath laying took place earlier this morning. You can see there is still a crowd of people coming by to remember Dr. King.
And here are live downtown pics. We're going down now to MLK Parade, where Max McGee joins us.
Max, let us know what's going on. It's just kicked off, right?
Lynn and Tim, hello there. MLK Day is a relatively new federal holiday, and there are a few long-standing traditions, but of course we do have a parade. Check out the scene here. We have fancy cars. We have all the fraternities here. There has to be a couple thousand people here on North Utah Street. I mean, the atmosphere here is so incredible. You have the live music. Of course, bear with me through all the announcements here. And of course, MLK Day is held on the third Monday of January and of course celebrates the life and achievements of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., a man who was so important to this country as we see it today. The parade comes just a day after Union Baptist Church held a concert for the holiday at the B&O Railroad Museum. They have a proud history of being involved in the civil rights movement dating back to 1892. Now take a look at this full screen right here. There's a list of traffic alerts for you. The parade will be held at the intersection of MLK Jr. Boulevard and Utah Street and end on Baltimore Street near Hoppleton. Road closures for you, those are important as well. Franklin Street between Green and Fremont are closed till 3:30, but access westbound to Route 40 is still good. Utah between Dolphin and MLK Boulevard is closed till 3 p.m. Of course, we're back now live at the parade. Looks like everyone is having a great time out here. So many people here. And for a full list of closures, just go to our website, WJZ.com. We're live in Baltimore City. I'm Max McGee for WJZ. Back to you.